It is very important, as a matter of life and death, that every black person asks any law enforcement personnel, during any and all encounters, in a very loud voice, is your video equipment properly recording this matter at this time, for your own safety? But, especially mine.
I shot the sheriff, but the spirit was in subdued.
Mamie Till Mobley, the mother of Emmett Till, once said, 2 months ago, I had a nice apartment in Chicago. I had a good job. I had a son. Whenever something happened to Negroes in the South, I said, that's their business, not mine. Now, I know how wrong I was. The murder of my son has shown me that what happens to any of us anywhere in the world had better be the business of all of us.
I know who giving knowledge up there, Tupac. He looking down like what happened to this hip hop.
The 10 Black Nation Codes of Conduct. 1. I am black first, before I am anything else, and all my alliance and total allegiances are as such, because I am black first. 2. I will not engage in display, support nor propagate anything that gives a negative reflection upon my black people, to include, but not limited to, news, entertainment, information, social media, etc. because I am black first. 3. I will spend my money within my black community first, and only spend the minimal amount elsewhere, until I am able to buy it in greater quantity from a black business owner, because I am black first. 4. Everything I make for or sell to my people will only be my best, and I will conduct all business transactions with my people in a decent, honorable and orderly manner, because I am black first. 5. I will not allow anyone to talk down upon, discredit, disenfranchise or discriminate against anyone black, because I am black first. 6. I will educate myself, family, friends and associates about world history, which is black history, because I am black first. 7. I will honor and align all my total allegiances with my black people, meaning any and all boycotts associated with black people is my business, and it warrants my full, complete and total cooperative support, because I am black first. 8. I understand having black pride does not negate anything nor anyone else, but it will foster an increase of self-respect, while uplifting all people to understand and respect my black people, because I am black first. 9. I will handle any and all personal issues about or with my black people within my own black community first, because we are black people first. 10. I will not allow media, law enforcement, politicians, political ties, friends, be it foreign or domestic or business associates nor etc., to speak about or concerning black issues. Without the support of an appropriate black official representative present. Because, my black people are my first priority. Because, I am unapologetically black, first.
And we study it's something very interesting, and we want to go over a couple of points that we haven't been able to touch on the details of. But there's a couple of interesting points that come up. But first of all, the Bible, the Holy Scriptures, is a book about black people. Many preachers and pastors might argue or disagree, say it's about everyone, or they might believe that the European Jews, the Hazars, and the converts are the actual Jews of the Bible, and they're free to, you know, believe or make believe. But the reality, when you study, this is why the scripture says study and show thyself approved. And this is not out of brothers and sisters, this is not a prideful, it's not out of no sort of pride. There are many who preach blackness in the Bible, and this one is black and that one is black, and a lot of it might have some evidence to it. It's circumstantial, albeit you overstand, but most of it's out of pride, right? This is not out of pride what we preach and what we are proclaiming here, and how serious and how very, very important it is that those who are able to receive this message receive it, and those who you're able to communicate this message communicate it. Pharaoh, right, in this spiritual Egypt that we're in, and DC, America, this shitstorm of things, right, that we're experiencing in 2013, is this spiritual Egypt. December 21st, the whole Mayan, you know, calendar, and the end of the world, and the polar shift, and the alignment, you know, something really did happen. Most folks are not able to see it. Some are prophetic, like Brother Manning, Reverend James David Manning. I hope I have his name in the right order. But you know, Reverend Manning from the Manning Report, he was saying it, even though, you know, ones might not be able to receive the fire, one cannot say that it's not red hot. You understand? And consistent in what he has been saying. And you know what? Perhaps we need to do this like this. You understand? That James David Manning, he was right. He is right, right on. But a lot of the folks can't see it. You know, we've checked out his videos early on when he, back in 2000, I think in 2008, when he first really started talking about the long-legged Mac Daddy. We've put out certain videos about certain things, and he was even compared with the Boondocks preacher. But if you look at the Boondocks preacher, the preacher in the Boondocks, and if you see it's about a consciousness level. Most folks are still dead, spiritually speaking. You understand? Or they're sleepwalking. You understand? Sleep talking. They're living in a dream and can't recognize the dream is becoming rapidly a nightmare. Yovas, and I say this to my brothers and sisters and others out there, check out what the good Reverend is stating, because some real sensible points. We might disagree about, you know, this or that on some matter, but the big issues, right? Because we're in spiritual Egypt. If you don't recognize that we're in spiritual Egypt, then you're blind to the real fact of the matter. And the portion that I wanted to touch on right here is that the new king, right? The new king did not want to let the Hebrews go. Now, some things get blurred by most pastors and preachers not studying the word. In the book of Exodus, it touches on the Hebrews. It uses two different type of descriptors, a general descriptor, like if you draw two circles, if you have a circle, draw a circle and you put a dot in it. That big circle is the Hebrews, right? We can say like the true Christians or the true people of the true faith of the God and Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is those folks, right? Those who seek to live it in spirit and in truth. Now, folks may say, well, is he black? Is he white? So forth and so on. Is his spirit your spirit? Is his blood your blood? You know what I'm saying? Is his flesh your flesh in spirit and in truth? That's the real point of the matter, is doing, hearing the word, feeling it, receiving it in your heart, declaring with your mouth, and doing it with your full might to the best of your ability, trusting in him as the source, right? As that source. But in this scripture right here, we're turning to Exodus chapter 1, and it is a very important point, and we want to name this that spiritual Egypt, right, and her Pharaoh doesn't want to let the lost sheep or the Hebrews go. They don't want to let them go. At the same time, doesn't want their population to increase, right? We saw a video that Reverend James David Manning had on, and it was talking about Chicago and what's going on in the death and the murder rate in Chicago. We haven't heard a word about that. Yovas, even right now with the Sandy hoax. Yes, it's a hoax. Don't you recognize there's a cult witchcraft going on? You understand? With over 4 years of the so-called first black president, African-American president, and he is more African. You know, he's the Kunta Kinte African, not the Toby African, if you understand that right there, that there's been over 1,800 murders of black men, women, and children. And especially the black young men, and even recently, one of the girls, young girls, who marched in the so-called inauguration of Barack Hussein Obama, she was just murdered. But you hear nothing about that. Why is that? Now, when you really look at Exodus and you look at the Bible, right, without any pride, not a prideful, let's look at each so-called race or group of people. Right. And then let's look at the blessings and the curses, right, that are mentioned in the Bible concerning God's people. And let's see who it really stacks up to be. You see, some folks say, well, because the European Jews got the state of Israel in 1948, well, that fulfills God's prophecy. OK, let's say you got that one right there. How about Deuteronomy chapter 28? You understand? Verses 15 to verse 16. How about that? Can you explain that from the European converted Jewish perspective? You cannot. You understand? You cannot. We challenge you if you can. We'll look for that vid, or we'll look for that book. We'll look for that research or whatever. Post it up there. Link it to us, and we'll see it as we see it. You understand? We'll check it out. You understand? They won't take this challenge. They haven't taken this challenge on before. But when you look into this particular area of scripture, right? And I was thinking about this. In fact, when you read it in the